Hey you guys, what's up? It's Nicole Dion with Eyebrow Studio. Let me know if you can hear me. Let me know if you can see me. I'm hoping I'm not connected to my Wi-Fi. I know that sounds a little strange, but for some reason it just does better on data. So anyway, what's up tonight? What are you guys sipping on? I have a little drink here. It's actually a non-alcoholic beverage. I'm sipping on a little bit of lemon juice and mineral water tonight. It's so good. I'm gonna set that back here just so I don't have an oops and like spill it anywhere. So this is what I'm sipping on tonight. Seltzer water. It's from Germany. It's a natural mineral water, so it's not carbonated. It's carbonated, but naturally carbonated. And then I just have a little bit of organic lemon juice. I got all of this at Sprouts. So it makes a really refreshing drink. It's kind of cold tonight, but it still makes a nice refreshing drink, especially if I'm gonna be talking a lot tonight. So seltzer water and lemon juice, really good. Let me know if you can hear me. We are listening to Chill House tonight, Amazon Music. Kind of had to ditch the XM radio and signed up for Amazon Music. Amazon everything, right? I love Amazon. If you would just say hello, let me know that everything is working okay. That way if I have to hop off and hop back on, I'll do all that. But hey, Angela, what's going on tonight? Can you see me okay? Is the connection okay? I'm a little concerned that my phone turned on its Wi-Fi again, and I don't want the Wi-Fi on tonight. Okay, so this Friday night, I'm doing a photo sesh. And actually, I think I'm going to be doing it with a friend of mine, one of my best friends, Abby. We're going to be doing a New Year's Eve photo sesh together, which I'm excited about. So that's what tonight's look. I'm going to create something for Friday. You guys can help me. And then I have my hair wrapped up tonight. I do have some tools behind me. I have some tools in front of me. This is a mess over here. But I will show you how I fluff up my fine hair. I have really fine hair. Let's see. It's only have this half of the screen. Here, let me see over here. Who else is on here tonight? Let me know if you can see me. I'm going to hop onto my computer really quick and see. You know, sometimes Facebook messes up and all that. And I don't want to be like half a screen. Am I half a screen to everybody tonight? Let me see what my... Okay, on mine it shows me normal. Which is weird that I'm half a screen on you. Huh, okay. It shows normal on my end. So I'm sorry I'm half a screen on yours. All right, I'm not sure where to start tonight. Let's see. Okay, I have some new things that I'm gonna be playing with. I went and got some glitter, some gold glitter. I kind of want to do like a smoke and mirrors kind of look. So some bling, but also some like smoky as well. So I guess we'll just jump in and get started. I usually always start with my foundation. I'm kind of like hesitant a little bit. I'm like, should I do my eyes first? I don't know. Let's start with the skin. So the skin, I want it to look very luminous, very dewy, very glowy. I don't want matte at all. I want to shine like a beam of light. So I'm gonna use some BB cream. That might have been a little too much. A little bit goes a long way. And I'm gonna mix a little bit of Ola Mode in with this. There we go. This is Luminizer. This is probably, honestly, way too much to start with, but that's okay. Are you able to hear me okay, though, Angela? I'm hoping so. We're listening to the Chill House Amazon. Have you guys switched over to Amazon Music? I don't know. I had Spotify for a while, and then had XM Radio, and now I have Amazon Music. Amazon's taking over the world, you guys, and it's pretty good. Hopefully it won't shut off though. How was everyone's holiday? Hey Kayla, how are you doing? What's going on? Did you guys have a good holiday? Anybody ready for kids to go back to school? I am. My house looks like a toy bomb went off. Like, serious. So I'm ready for school to start. Hey, Kayla, what's going on? How was your guys' holiday? Okay, so I added a little bit of luminizer. Okay, I put this in BB cream. Great holiday, but been sick. Oh, I'm sorry. Now my stomach's been kind of like mad at me lately, but I don't think it's because I'm sick. So TMI, you guys, sorry. But I ate some garlic, raw garlic. Because it's supposed to be good for you, it's supposed to kill candida and all that stuff. And normally I take a garlic supplement and don't just eat raw garlic. But I decided to do my hippie stuff and ate raw garlic. And so ever since I did that, my stomach hurts, and it's probably because it's like killing candida and all that stuff, but I feel sick. And it's been going on for like a week. It's terrible. So note to self, don't eat raw garlic. Okay, one time I juiced some garlic and took a shot of garlic juice. It dropped me to my knees. I thought I was going to die. Like, seriously, it was like the worst experience of my life. So why did I think about years later eating a garlic clove? I don't know. Glad it's over. Yeah, I guess it is. All the hustle and bustle. It's been kind of nice though for me. Like, I just been working half days this week, so that's been really nice. I think my phone's delayed a little bit. What's the little like cheese face for? The garlic story? Yeah, I try some things. I try like different herbal remedies, and I'll go do that stuff first before I do medication. I am definitely very more holistic in my thinking. Sometimes that's a good thing. Most of the time it's a good thing. The garlic thing was not a good thing. That was pretty, that was rough. Don't do it. Don't do it. Okay, so I should be looking more luminous, light reflective. And then I'm gonna grab another luminizing stick. And I just wanna glow. Strobe lights. Black light. I got some awesome eyelashes tonight. Look at those. Aren't those pretty? I'm in love with these. And then got, well, I have the lip sparkle. I'm not sure if I'm going to use it or not. It's hard to see it. But look at that. Isn't that pretty? Oh, I have a sweater right here and I was gonna wipe the glitter on it. Don't do that, don't do that. I have some glitter glue. I don't know if I'll use that tonight or not. I finally have clear lip gloss, right? Oh, do you have the lip sparkle? I love the lip sparkle. It's amazing. Okay, I think I am glowing enough. Let's go to the eyes. I was gonna use palette 5, but I might use this one here. Let me see. So palette 5 has that pretty gold. Can you see it? And then here's another gold. I'm not sure which one to use. I think this one looks more gold. Let's go with that. And if I wanna change my mind later, we can. So you guys are helping me pick out my look for Friday. You guys do anything fun for New Year's Eve? Any New Year's resolutions? Anything that you have to do this coming year? You know what I want to start doing? It's ever since I've had the baby, I just kind of like a hermit and stay at home. Not really a hermit, but I just don't go out and do too many things. So that's one of my personal goals, is to, you know, allow myself not to have the mom guilt and go do stuff, you know? So like in my 20s, because I had two of my kids in my 20s, I guess I just thought I was gonna have the two. So I always thought, well, you know, there'll be adults right around when I'm going to be 40. And I'll be 40 coming up here in February, February 1st. And so I always thought, you know, I'll live my life then. You know what I mean? Well, if I have that same mentality now, I won't be living my life till I'm 60. So I think it's a good idea for me to start learning to like hire sitters and allow myself to go do stuff every once in a while. You know what I'm saying, you guys? Let's see. Hey, Angie, how's it going? Hey, Kimberly, how's it going tonight? That is a good one. Live your life and have some fun. Yeah. Well, and you don't have to be like pigeonholed, right? Like you don't have to go. I mean, I can do stuff, right? With my kids or hire a sitter or do something else, you know? Like I can figure it out. But I get mom guilt really easy because I'm, you know, usually at work all day and then get home and I feel mom guilt to go work out. So I usually don't go work out. I don't think this is bold enough for what I want. So I'm gonna switch. Hey, Kimberly, how's it going? Hey, Angie. See, I'm coming to see you soon. Yay, just need to make an appointment. Do it, girl. Oh, you guys, I'm doing a giveaway. My first giveaway for my lives. So all you have to do is go to join my list. There's a link here somewhere. You don't have to do it now, do it after. And then just sign up and then you'll be entered to win some goodies from me. Yay! What color splurge eyeshadow? What do you think? I think it's too like dim, but it's, where'd it go? I was like, I don't want to use it. Got rid of it. There it is. It's pretty. It's just, I don't feel like it's as bold, or maybe it's my lighting. It's called Extravagant. So it's not the new metallic, but it is sparkly. So I got this from my grandson's for Christmas. Isn't that sweet? And this headband, so I had to wear it. Okay, so I'm gonna take the deluxe brush. Let me clean it off just in case I have another color on there. Some people use those fancy little tins. I just use towels. I mean, it's easy. Okay, I'm gonna take this gold. Let's see if this will make it pop a little bit more. Now the splurge can be used for a pop of color or as a primer and make the color pop more. That's what I'm trying to say. I have that one and it really pops when I use primer. The splurge pops when you use primer or palette 5. Oh yeah, I think that's better. That's a little bit more what I'm going for. So I want it to be really vibrant. So I think I'm gonna keep those two in a combination. Well, that's a great idea, Kayla. I've never actually used primer with the splurge cream before, so I'll have to give that a try. Really, I haven't really used splurge cream a whole lot. And I'm really just getting into them. I really like it. I didn't think they would blend very well, but they actually do blend really good. Hey, Kendall, how's it going tonight? Make sure I didn't miss anybody. Okay. All right, so the smoke. I'm gonna use palette 2. I'm kind of debating on this one here. I like that color. What do you think? It kind of gives it a little bit of shimmer, but it's still smoky. Let's see if it's smoky enough. Do you have a good holiday, Kendall? I still have my tree up. My living room is toy bombed. I don't like a lot of clutter or a lot of stuff. So I think this weekend we'll be going through some old toys and saying farewell and giving them another home. Okay, this one is Zealous. What do you think? You're sick too? Everybody's sick. Oh, I guess we all got together with family and either got food poisoning or a cold. I'm sorry that you're sick. That really sucks. My stomach's been kind of upset, so I've been drinking lemon seltzer water. You'll have to watch the replay. I did some wacky stuff with garlic, so. We had a great Christmas, but then I got a kidney infection. Okay, that's not fun. I can't even imagine what the heck. That sounds painful. To be hospitalized for that kind of stuff? I'll have to look and see what like herbal supplements help with that. Or maybe just water? Or, I don't know. Do you get those often or was that your first one? Oh, that's pretty. I love this color. Okay, and now I'm going to use Elated. And just dust that up here. Blend that out a little bit. Okay. Better do the other side. I don't want to forget exactly what I'm doing. Yeah, I think a lot of you guys are under the weather. I think my under the weather was self-induced by eating raw garlic. Some people are sensitive to that, from what Google says. I can't wait for this look to be all pulled together with the false lashes. Get my hair out of this wrap. My bangs might be a little funky tonight. I feel like I have to blow dry them. I've had three other ones and have been to the hospital and they caught this one in time. Yikes. I gotta figure out how to prevent those for you. Oh, you need to follow Chris Carr, K-R-I-S-C-A-R-R, I think, or it might be the opposite way. It might be it's K-R-I-S-C-A-R-R. She's like this holistic health guru who had stage 4 breast cancer and there was no hope for her. Like, they told her basically, why does this side look different? They basically told her that there was no hope. There's no reason to do chemo or anything like that. And gosh, I've been following her for like at least 7 years or more. So she's obviously beat it. So follow her. She has a lot of good information. Hopefully it'll be helpful. I feel like this one looks different and it could just be my light. I don't know what's going on there. I'll just darken this side. Maybe it'll match up. So do you guys have any funny stories or anything that happened over the holidays? So last week I told you guys that I got my son the Xbox. And I don't know if you're following me on my personal page or not, but I posted his reaction. He was so excited. He did not expect it at all. He like literally had a heart attack right here in the living room. They do look the same. Okay, thanks, Kendall. Hey, Nita. How's it going tonight? Yeah, I feel like the lighting on this side is... I need a better light. I have a great light at work. Okay. Let me make sure I soften that. I don't remember if I did. I got a razor for Christmas that I asked for and shaved off part of an eyebrow? No! Oh no, Kendall. Oh no. Kendall shaved off part of her eyebrow with her Christmas gift. Now that's a nightmare. Okay, I do have a story for you guys about someone shaving their eyebrows. So it was probably several years ago now. I had a gal walk into the eyebrow studio and she said, I shaved my eyebrows. Like, she took a hair razor, like a buzzer, and buzzed her eyebrows. And her eyebrows looked like a 5 o'clock shadow, the poor thing. And she was like, can you do anything for me? I will try. I will definitely try. So I tinted I like did eyebrow dye on her little nubs and shaped her 5 o'clock shadow. And it worked. She looked at least like she had like something there instead of like nothing. Like, poor thing. Now that was a nightmare. That's probably the worst one I ever seen. And everyone always thinks I'm around, out judging people on their eyebrows. I don't. I don't know why. It's like if you're right here in front of me and I have your eyebrows in front of me, then I'm like, okay, I know what we can do. But when I'm out walking around, unless they're super dramatic, I don't usually like analyze. You know, that would just drive me crazy if I did something like that. I guess it'd be like walking around, you know, looking in a magnifying mirror or something. Oh, okay, I'm using Forthright underneath. Oh my God, I just saw some fake eyebrows on Wish.com. Now that would be hilarious. You put one on, and then as you're going throughout your day, and you're doing your stuff, and then it comes down to here, and then you got yourself a little mustache. Hey Danny, how's it going? Thanks for hopping on. Okay, I think I'm gonna take the gold from Palette 5 again and go underneath. I'm gonna take this one and smoke that out a little bit. And I'm gonna wait to put on my concealer. But see, this is usually why I do everything before those, because like if my eye makeup is like exaggeratedly low, I don't want to like mess it up. So I probably should have put my concealer on. Okay, let's do eyebrows. And then soon I will put on this glitter. Look at that. Isn't that pretty? You guys have fun New Year's plans? Danny, Kayla. So I know you girls always go do fun stuff together. You guys have figured it out how to be moms and do fun stuff. Okay, I'm gonna grab my palette. Here it is. Here is my Brow Obsession palette. Oh, I forgot to tell you, I have this golden glitter hairspray. So we might be playing around with that too. Okay, eyebrows. Let me find my eyebrow brush. There we go, Brow Artist Brush. So there's a couple ways you can do it, and I'm not quite sure if I like actually using this first. Now I've showed people how to like tap this in and like create a more firm line. I don't know what I like better. And I think it's just like a personal preference and what look you're going for. I'm gonna start out with the darker color. And I'm gonna line. So did you buy those fake eyebrows? Maybe they just stay on just like eyelashes. Okay, we're gonna start with my least favorite eyebrow. And this little eyebrow here has to be tinted because I have a gray hair in there that I discovered a while back, and it's back. That's the thing. I'm like, I used to do a lot of raw, like fruits and veggies and green smoothies. I mean, a lot more than just one green smoothie that I tell everybody to do for your skin, you know, but I really feel like because I started being kind of busy, being a little bit more neglectful with like how healthy, how clean I eat, that I've noticed, you know, a few more gray hairs. Now I know age has to do with it, but there are women who are like, I mean, this might sound extreme to you, but 70-year-old vegans, if you look that up, they look like they're maybe 40. So there is some truth to having like that raw fruits and vegetables, really getting your vitamins and your enzymes and all that. And I hope to make sure I start doing that again. It really benefited me, and I always felt great when I did that. Let's see. I would love to do something on New Year's Eve, but we'll be taking care of my mom all weekend. Is your mom not doing good? No, but they actually didn't look weird. Just needed some shaping. Hopefully mine will grow back soon. Yeah, they'll grow back. Maybe go get a brow tint, a brow color. Once they start growing back, it'll help. Or you can fill them in. Do you have one of these? I think that one turned out okay. This is like my nemesis eyebrow. And I do have them soft tapped. It's not the person who soft tapped my eyebrows' fault that my eyebrows are different. She actually made them look as similar as possible. So this is actually a better version of my eyebrow. And eyebrows are sisters, not twins. That's true. It really is a true statement. Sometimes the hair grows different from one side to the other. Kind of have to concentrate here for a second. But yeah, I definitely overplucked them when I was young. What should I do on my 40th birthday, you guys? So my 9-year-old, his birthday is in February as well. His is February 12th. So we definitely have a date. We're gonna go, I'm gonna let him skip school. I don't know which day, but, and we're gonna go to, I think we're gonna have lunch on the Devon Tower. He's always wanted to do that. I told him we'd do that and leave the baby with Miss Janet. So there's light, medium, dark brow obsession palettes. I'm using the dark. So outline with the darkest color in your palette. Fill in the tell. And then get into the lighter color. My 40th is in a year. I have a year to figure it out. So 2019. No, but they actually, okay. I think I'm caught up. When's your birthday, Angie? I mean, I definitely want to do something. I just don't know what. But I don't have a year to figure it out. I have, I guess, a month and a few days to figure it out. Oh, December 5th. Okay. Yeah, I'm actually pretty excited. It's like, once you reach that milestone, you're like, yes! So weird because, like, you know, a lot of people cry on their birthdays. Even in my 20s, I was always, like, exaggerating my age a little bit. I always wanted to be, like, a little bit older. I think especially with the industry that I'm in because, like, even when you try to give somebody, like, good advice for, like, their skin and stuff like that, you hear, oh, you just have good genes, or, oh, you're just young, and you're like, well, yeah, but you have to take care of yourself. We went on a cruise for Melinda and Rose's 40th. It was awesome. Ooh, that could be fun. It's a little bit too late for me to do that, I think. Don't you think? Only, like, a month away. So I'll probably be local. Plus, I'm doing baby steps of letting myself do stuff without the kids. Because I just don't ever have a night alone. My alone time is like right now and when I'm at the studio. So those look okay, you guys? Do those match? You are my eyes. A cruise would be so fun. Kayla and Danny just got back from a cruise. This is just a little bit of clear brow gel. Okay, I think we're gonna leave them. And then let's get into the sparkle one this time. Last time we used the pink, which is really pretty. But I want things to be sparkly tonight. I grab my concealer brush. And just add a little bit of glimmer. And this also just straightens up any lines, you know? It was fun. I want to go on another one. I have not been on a cruise. Do you have to have passports? Well, I guess now, don't we all have to have passports to leave Oklahoma by airplane? But I guess we can drive. Okay, let's put on the glitter. And I'm not sure if it's gonna stick to my eye or not. I don't think it will. I think I'm gonna go ahead and try this. It's a glitter glue. And let me see who it's by. Bitsy? Bitsy, I don't think you can read that, but. Bitsy glitter glue. And I don't know exactly where I want it. Let's just start in the center. Well, that's pretty. Okay, I think I want most of the lid covered in that. Yes, this is the look that I was wanting to go for. Yeah, that's sparkly. You've never been on one either, Kendall? That should be on our bucket list. The one place I have to go someday is Jamaica. I have to go to Jamaica. I've been wanting to go since I was 12. So that's telling you, that's a long time. So I'm just patting on the glue. And I've never used a glitter glue before. But you definitely don't want to wipe. Because it can wipe off your eye makeup. Isn't it pretty? So sparkly. I think I want to go a little bit more bold with my underneath part. Especially because I'm going to be putting on some crazy eyelashes here in just a second. I'm wondering if I should have put my lashes on first, but we'll see if they stick with this glitter. Wow, that shows up so nicely. I'm gonna put a little bit here. Yeah, I love it. You guys approve? You like it? Okay, so for blush, since everything's really creamy today, I wanted to use a lipstick. So we're gonna use Sitting Pretty. And we're gonna give that a try. I love that lipstick color, like a lot. Okay, let's conceal just a little bit. Maybe clean this line up. I'm digging this channel. On XM, they had like a chill channel, and this is Amazon Music, and they have a chill channel. This one's called Chill House. Hopefully I'll get a better ring light here in the near future. pretty. I wouldn't have thought of that. Oh, the lipstick. Well, I didn't want to put anything cream or powdery on over my cream. So you know how last week we did the splurge cream for contour? I want to do that again. So I'm going to do that for contour. We're going to do this for blush. And we already did the highlights. So, all right, let me see here. Which brush do I want to use? That's the dilemma. Okay, let's start with the lighter color first. I love this lipstick. Do you guys know the story about Sitting Pretty? Because if you do, I won't repeat it. I tell this story all the time. So if you're like, please don't bore us with that Sitting Pretty story, I won't. And if you have no idea what I'm talking about, look up uniquefoundation.org and it'll tell you all about what I'm talking about. This is an awareness lipstick. And I love it because it's a really pretty soft pink and it's iridescent. Oh, Kendall, you don't know the story? Okay, so Sitting Pretty is an awareness lipstick. It's iridescent. It is pretty. See, Sitting Pretty. Wow, it goes on good as a blush, doesn't it? It's an awareness lipstick for uniquefoundation.org, which is a retreat, the Haven Retreat, which is free 4-day retreat for women who were sexually abused as children. See, it's an awareness lipstick. Now you guys know. And if you know somebody or yourself would love to go to that, just go to uniquefoundation.org and fill out the application and get on the list. All you have to do is get yourself there and you're in. So go check it out if you need that. All right, I'm gonna try out this contouring again. I'm using a splurge cream. I always like getting this spot right here. I'm surprised you never heard that story, Kendall. Or maybe you just didn't know the lipstick was connected to that story. So you guys, if you own one of these, I don't know if you saw my video I posted earlier this week about your goals and your dreams and your future plans. Don't use magnifying mirrors. Now that has nothing to do with, it does have a lot to do with dreams and goals and stuff too. So watch that live. Actually, I didn't do it live. It's pre-recorded. But go watch that when you get a chance. But seriously, I always tell clients, don't look in one of these things because it lies to you. So last weekend, I can't remember what day it was, but I'm in holiday land. I don't know what day it is. But I took this mirror over to this window over there and I was like, oh my gosh, I have a beard. And I went to my sons. I'm like, do I have a beard? They're like, what beard, mom? You don't have a beard. Magnifying mirrors are like the devil, you guys. They really are. They lie so much. They make you think you have big pores when you don't. They make you feel like you have terrible skin when you actually don't. And any facial hair you feel like is, 10 inches, even though it's not. I think I like the splurge cream as a contour. You see in person. Yeah, that's really pretty. It blends nice. Then we'll get our lips on and then we'll do some hair. Gosh, here's the thing about magnifying mirrors too. Like if you go to grab one, you can't even see in it. It's like everything's blurry until you like zoom in. I hate that thing. I can't see to put on my mascara without a magnifying mirror. Well, that's the exception, right? As long as you don't go like looking at all your flaws, because it's not true flaws, right? It's not true. But if you need it for seeing, that's completely different. Oh, thank God for contour. You guys contour. I can't wait to show you my hair tools. So I kind of do, I kind of cut my hair. I kind of do my own hair. I have really fine, baby fine hair. I do that enough without looking in a mirror. You do what? Pick yourself apart? I hope that's not what you mean. Don't do that. You love it? You love the splurge cream? Or the contour, just contour in general, right? It just like really chisels out the features and makes them look like, ooh, bam. Yeah, I hope you're not saying that you don't need a magnifying mirror to pick apart flaws. You guys, oh, look for flaws. No, we gotta love ourselves. We have to love ourselves. So important, right? In this life, in our life journey, is to learn to embrace. Let me tell you a story. Learn to embrace your flaws. But okay, that's what I was gonna say. But let me tell you a story. This whole side of my face is covered in scars. I have scars here, in my eyebrow, all over here. So until I learned to embrace them, I feel like I always got questions about it. Like, what happened to your face? Did you get bit by a dog? What's wrong with the side of your face? Like, I feel like I heard that a lot. And then when I just like chose to embrace something about myself, that really wasn't gonna change. Guess what happened? It was like something magical happened. People don't see them anymore. So I think when we focus on our flaws, what happens is it draws attention to it. But when we embrace those things that we really have no control over, that we can't change, and we just love ourselves the way we are and give ourselves that grace, then it really just changes the energy around that. Does that make sense? So that's what I've had to learn in my personal life. Thankfully, I learned that kind of young. I mean, I don't know if you can see them, but and then I have stretch marks. So I had to learn to love those too. I have four kids, got all my stretch marks from the first one. That's not fair, but some people don't have that, you know, but I do. And it's just part of it. And you just wear around your flaws with pride. You just love them. Because your flaws make you who you are, you know? Oh, why am I taking my hair down? I was like ready to do my hair, but you can see how fine my hair is, right? Super fine. Well, if you were here in person, you could. Let me go a little closer. See right here? But it's because I don't draw attention to them anymore. I used to draw attention to my flaws because I would like, you know, try to hide it or, you know, turn my face a certain way. Those things that us ladies do to like hide our flaws, and then it really draws attention to it. Just gotta embrace it, live with it, love it. Okay. I'm using Stellar. It's a liquid lipstick, and it's kind of like, I don't want to say a sensitive subject to me, as far as like, you know, as we are blessed to get to continue to be in this life and to get older and everything like that, if we're lucky enough, then we have to start embracing changes in our body, you know? So I think we really need to make sure that we change our mindset about ourselves. Thank you, Kendall. You know, because this body's temporary. So we just gotta make the most of it. And just love ourselves no matter what. But the reason why it's kind of like, oh, I don't know what the right word is. It's not a sensitive subject, but it means something to me, is because my grandma, from what I've heard, she won't let herself go out of the house. Isn't that gorgeous? She won't let herself go out of the house because she has aged and she doesn't like the way she looks. So That, to me, is really heartbreaking, and I don't want anybody to go through that, you know? So loving ourselves sometimes can be a struggle. But that's where those positive affirmations come in. You have to do it every day. Journaling. Really embracing who you are and realizing that you are magnificent and you're a beautiful goddess. Because it's not what the outside, right, defines you. It's who have you become? What has the journey brought through? What have you gone through? What has it developed in you? Thanks, Kayla. Thank you, Angie. So I was thinking about putting the lip sparkle on this. I don't know. I have the clear. I finally have the clear. I haven't had a clear lip gloss in a long time. My mom hated to go anywhere when she had to wear oxygen. She says kids stared. Yeah. I have heard things like that too. I can't remember. Somebody told me recently like their dad was embarrassed to go out because of some type of condition. And I'm sure that's challenging, you know? But it's better to have a quality of life, right? But that would be a challenge. That would definitely be some like inner work needing to happen. So I can't say that that would be easy, you know? And kids, they're just curious. They don't know any better. I love this lip sparkle. I wish I can give you a link to it, but there is no link to it. This was a little 24-hour deal. Did you see that little dust there? Isn't that pretty? Oh, look. Happy New Year. Oh, this is so pretty. Thank you. It's Stellar Liquid Lipstick. All right, let's do eyelashes, and then let's get this hair looking fluffy. All right, lashes. I got Mega Volume Lashes by Ardell. Fairy dust, yeah. Little pixie dust. These are 253s. And first, what you're going to do, if you've never put these on before, you're going to measure your eye. You just take the lash, measure it, make sure it's going to fit. Oop. Okay. I really like the Ardell glue. There's a lot of different opinions about which glue to use. But I absolutely like using a paint-on glue. I think it's time for me to get a new one. So I'm hoping my glitter won't be a problem. Maybe I should use a mirror. Okay, I think it's gonna work, actually. Oh, it's coming together, isn't it? Each little layer. Yes, that looks great. Boy, it's kind of like life, you know, since we're talking about all of that. It's like every little thing that we go through, it's like a little layer that makes things more beautiful, makes you more beautiful as a person. So if the holidays have been hard for you and you've had a really rough 2017, it is a time of transformation, even if it doesn't feel like it. But when you get to the other side, you'll see. Okay, I always hook it onto the center first. Aren't they gorgeous? 253 Ardell. Now, I did post links in the description for most of everything I'm using tonight. So I think that's like the biggest question I get is like, why is there no links? Where do I get that? So that's what I did. So now you guys can recreate this look for New Year's Eve if you like. So should this be my look for my pictures? So we need a little bit of mascara on the bottoms. Hey Sarah, how's it going tonight? Right, it's a process to get to this point. You should have saw me when I hopped on. Anything worth going for, anything worth having, it takes a process sometimes. Just like doing a makeup. Oh yeah, coming together. Love you too, Sarah. Glad you could hop on. All right, now we're gonna go to hair. I'm not gonna put any powder on or anything because I don't want that look. I don't want a powdery look at all. I just want shimmer, glimmer. Maybe just do a little bit of setting spray. Put everything in place. Get a little bit more light reflective going on. All right, I'm gonna turn on my tools. Okay, so the first tool that if you have fine hair, if you're lucky and you have fluffy hair and it's thick and full and luscious and it doesn't look like this. I mean, look at my ponytail. It's like, if I have a ponytail, it's like this little, you guys. Like if I have pigtails, it's just not a lot. That's just, I have a quarter Filipino in me. And I have straight, fine Asian hair. Now I know some, you know, it's probably not fair. There's some people who have really thick Asian hair, but I have the stick straight Asian hair. So I'm gonna put this on a medium setting because I have fine hair. I don't want to burn my hair. So I'm gonna turn this on. Hey Alyssa, just now getting to join. I'll rewatch from the beginning. You look amazing. Awesome, thanks. Well, you hopped on just in time. This is what you wanted to check out. Okay, so I'm gonna turn on my flat iron because even though it's straight, it's still kind of, I'm gonna have to fix it a little bit. It's been in a ponytail. But see that temperature is 380. I don't want it 380 because I have fine hair. It needs to go down to 220. So we'll let that heat up there for a second. Okay. I'm in love with this. This is Amika dry shampoo and it helps like give some life to my hair. Now, even though I have fine hair, I can probably get away with two or three days without washing it as long as I have this. Even on the day I washed my hair, like I did today, I used the dry shampoo because I need texture to my hair. I don't have a lot of texture and this will help do that for me. I mean, see that little spray just there? Gave me a little bit of volume. I love dry shampoo. I don't love all dry shampoos. This has been my favorite that I've been able to find for my hair. Some dry shampoos are very strange. Okay, so then what I'm gonna do is, oh, you need one of these too if you have fine hair. Sorry, it's kind of gross. I should have cleaned that off before I hopped on. But I've had this forever, okay? It's beat up. But this is a ratting brush, not a comb. A ratting comb doesn't work for me. I have fine hair, it does not work. So I need the ratting brush. So I don't think most people, a lot of people understand fine hair. Fine hair is very complicated. It's oily on the scalp and dry at the end, so like for shampoo, I have to use very moisturizing shampoo and conditioner. But then on my scalp, I have to like dry it out a little bit. And when I started doing my own thing, my hair got healthier because here's what happened. I don't color treat my hair. I don't blow dry Well, I do blow dry my hair, but I only do it maybe like 2 or 3 times a week at the most. And my hair was so brittle. I could just like, because I was using shampoo for fine hair, which is so drying and it's terrible. So I have to use dry hair shampoo and treat my roots a little bit different. Kayla says, I have fine hair too. It's no fun. Yeah, but watch this. I mean, so you're going to crimp your roots. I did put a link for this bedhead crimper. It's an Amazon link. Who doesn't love Amazon? But just doing this little bit will help start to bring some volume. The main thing you don't want to do is you don't want to crimp it where you can see it. You want to crimp it underneath. I should have grabbed a hair clip. To be honest, I usually don't use one. Probably be helpful if I did. But this makes such a difference. Probably should give it a few more layers. Let's see. Yep, this is for volume. Sorry, my bangs are all wacky right now. And this is from having a baby, losing my hair a little bit. It's finally growing back. Okay. Let me get the center spot here. Yeah, if my hair is down, it typically is either day one or day two after washed. If it's up, it's probably dirty. Because if you have fine hair, you know that it is like grease, and no matter how much dry shampoo you do, it just still is an issue. See how some life is starting to come into it? Okay, let's do this side. And then I can like mess with my bangs and hopefully put them in place. I did have them pinned back this whole time. I need to do this. I saw advertisement on Facebook for this. Oh gosh, no, this is $20. I know what you're talking about. I saw the advertisement too. And I followed the Yellow Brick Road and went to their website, and it was like $100 something. No, this is a bedhead root crimper, $20 on Amazon. I don't remember if it's Amazon Prime or not, but no, you don't have to spend $130. Yeah, I feel bad for everyone who paid $130 for that. Because this works. Oh, I hear my little guy crying, you guys. Okay, let me really quickly show you what else I do. I use Resurrection Dust by Label.M, and I just sprinkle that in. Now, this is the fairy dust, Kendall. Can you crimp your whole hair with it? You probably could, but it's kind of skinny and it's small. I mean, I have crimped pieces of it before. I love this Resurrection Dust. I use it in the color Brunette. And I haven't even ratted my hair yet, and there's definitely more volume. So then what I normally do is then I take this ratting brush, and now all those areas that I crimped, I just give it a little bit of a rat. And then it, see, look at that. See how it's puffing up? Sorry, guys, I'm probably gonna have to leave you here in just a couple seconds. I hear my little guy. What time is it? He usually does wake up one time at night, but not usually this early. My hair's super baby fine too. The only thing that helps me is when it's curly. Yeah, you try to get one of these. Tell me what you think. And then this Resurrection Dust, you just do this with your hair. And I didn't use my flat iron. I probably won't since I have to hop off, but now I have fuller hair. So, what do you guys think? I'm not sure how I'm gonna do my hair for pictures, but. All right, and then I set it with this. Thank you, Kayla. I love this hairspray. Nobody knows what I'm talking about when I say rose petal doll, but I had a rose petal doll when I was a little girl, and it smelled like roses, and I loved it. And I like this hairspray because it smells like that, but I like the hold. It's not heavy, but it holds everything in place. And it smells really good. And then, just for fun, I have, by that same company, Label.M, a hair perfume. And this just makes me feel happy. I think we should just do stuff that makes us feel happy. And I just spray a little bit in my hair. Then I feel, you know, happy and ready to go. I feel vibrant, feel feminine, sexy. Thank you, Alyssa. See? It looks fuller. That's how you do it. You just have to like baby your roots a little bit. Are you going to link the hairspray too? So I put all the links pretty much to everything. If I missed something, somebody let me know. I did post it here in the description. Also, before you hop off, I am doing a contest. So if you go to, oh my gosh, join my list. That's what it is. And that's just on my Facebook page. I did post it in the description as well, that you'll be entered to win some goodies from me. It's my first giveaway. And thank you guys for hopping on for my second Nick at Night makeup sesh. This was fun. So glad you guys are here. He might have went back to sleep. Maybe. I don't know. I better hop off anyways just to go check on him. All right, you guys, I think I showed you everything. Everything I used is listed. I will see you next week. Hope you'll join me again Wednesday, 9:30. See you then. Have a good night, you guys. Bye.